Hello friends, welcome to your very own channel Soni Singh Physics. In this video, I have highlighted some of the common mistakes what you do while drawing best fit line in your physics paper. I have also discussed how to avoid it. This video will be helpful for you in alternative to practical paper 6-2 and structure paper 4-2 also. So let's watch it. Don't do these mistakes while drawing best fit line in alternative to practical paper 6-2. Can you tell me what are the mistakes in this graph? Marks awarded in this graph is 3 out of 4. Look carefully. This is the graph. We will check each point and you have to check with me. This is the graph. First question is, the graph axis has labeled correctly? Answer is yes. Second question is, a good choice of scale? Answer is yes. A well just straight line is there? Answer is yes. Plots are correct in size and students have used neat crosses. Is it there? Answer is no. So here is the mistake. Actually, plot should be medium in size. The student should have used neat crosses or circle dots. So because of this, the student has lost one mark over here. But there is another common mistake which students do more often is a poor choice of scale that results in the plots occupying less than half the graph grid in one or both directions. Like this. Look at this graph. The graph is just in a corner. Actually, it's supposed to be more than half of the graph paper. Actually, you should select the scale which can occupy more than half graph grid in both the directions. Like this. Another question about graph is, determine the gradient of the graph. Show clearly on the graph how you obtained the necessary information. And the mark awarded here is 1 out of 2. So let's see what is the mistake happen in this question. Where student has lost marks. If you check graph in previous slide, the triangle to calculate gradient is too small. It uses less than half of the line. So that's the mistake. This is another common mistake shown by students. Drawing a triangle that uses less than half of the line or failing to show the triangle clearly on the graph. These are steps to draw line of best fit. First is, determine a scale, the numerical value for each square or division that best fits the range of each variable. Second is, use a scale that allows your data to be graphed as large as possible in the space provided. Third is, the range of each axis may be different. They do not need to start at zero, but it is recommended as this allows you to extrapolate if needed. I'll tell you what is the meaning of extrapolation. The scale of each axis may be different, but each one must be consistent. Consistent means if one division represents 1 meter at the beginning of the graph on one axis, one division always represents 1 meter on that axis. So on the same axis, there should not be change. Next is, identify a trend or a relationship between the independent and dependent variables. What are the independent and dependent variables? You can watch in my another video. In description, you can get the link of that. Remove any outliers from consideration. Outliers means the point which is not coming in the trend of the graph. We say these points as anomalous points, so we can avoid those points to bring in the line of best fit. Draw a curve or a line that best describes the identified trend. Most graphs of experimental data in physics are linear and not drawn as connect the dots. Only draw the line over the range for which you have data. Do not extend your line beyond this range. If required to extrapolate, extend the graph along the same slope beyond the range of data. Use a dotted line to indicate that you are extrapolating. What is extrapolation? So these are two pictures through which you can understand extrapolation. These red lines are extrapolated lines in this graph. Here you can see the green color, that is in the beginning and towards the end of the graph, that is called extrapolation. Thank you for watching. I hope this video will be helpful for you towards understanding your best fit line in your physics paper 6-2 and 4-2. If you have any question, write in comment box. I will get back to you soon. Please do like and subscribe to your very own channel, Soni Singh Physics. Thanks again.